Hello everyone, welcome to this topic of database recovery during transaction execution. Now you can very well understand that if a transaction is executing in the database, then different type of errors can occur as well as failures. For example, power can go off, RAM can fail, hard disk can crash, network error can come, etc. So keeping this thing in mind, let us move ahead. See, there can be different types of failures. For example, there can be transaction failure, system failure, and disk failure. Now transaction can fail due to either some logical error or maybe due to some system error. Logical error can be division by zero, no proper exception handling or else, and system error can be due to some deadlock or any other reason. System crash means either power failure or software failure or any type of failure, maybe network failure. And third type, which is very common, is storage failure or disk failure. So any of these type of failures can cause your transaction to abort in between. So we need to develop mechanism so that database can recover from these type of failures. For example, if you are transferring money from account A to B, it can happen that money from A has been deducted but not transferred to B and the power fails. So there are different aspects of failure recovery, and in order to implement them, you need to have proper recovery algorithms. So algorithms are outlined with that are implemented by DBMS developing companies so that the durability property of transaction in case of asset properties is 100% ensured. Okay. As well as the system can recover from any type of failure. Now, every recovery algorithm has two parts, as you can see. Number one, action tiering during normal transaction processing. Okay. And the action taken after the failure. It means, first of all, you need to take those actions that are used in case of failure during the normal execution of the transaction. Okay. And secondly, the action that are to be taken once the failure or error has occurred, so that atomicity, consistency, and durability are ensured. Okay. So with these concepts, let us move ahead. Now, the storage is also divided into various categories. Number one, we can call is volatile, like your RAM. It does not survive system failures. As soon as power goes off, something happens, all the data is lost. Non-volatile is where you can keep your data, that is hard disk, tape, DVD, pen drive, whatever is the case. And another term which is very common in database is stable storage. Now, what is a stable storage? Actually, you can see it's a mythical form. Now, why it is mythical? Because stable storage is a concept. There is nothing called stable storage, but stable storage means something which survives even after failure. Now, how it is done? See, if you maintain 5 copies of a transaction at 5 different locations, it is unlike that all the 5 different locations will have failure at the same time. So it means your strategy is to keep at least one copy safe. So what we want such kind of system where you can imagine that this will not fail, and there can be different techniques to do it. You can use multiple locations, you can use multiple hard disks, you can use multiple copies. There are different techniques used by different companies. It can be RAID, 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 or any other things. Okay. The main idea is we want something that survives any type of failure. Okay. So that is a general meaning of stable. Stable means something which was not affected by the failure. Okay. One thing more that you are very well aware that how data is accessed. The data is accessed through blocks. Those blocks are either on hard disk or in RAM. Okay. And if you see this chart, it is very well clear to you that whenever a transaction is doing read A, that data is read from the hard disk and is brought to the RAM. And if any transaction is doing any write, then again the data is read from the hard disk, it is brought into the buffer, and then any changes are done into that buffer. Okay. And then it is written to hard disk. Okay. So in general, write Y for a transaction, maybe write is done in RAM, but it is not 100% always true that this Y has been written to hard disk. Okay. But for user, write Y means changes has been done. So this concept comes into picture. Okay. So as per transaction is concerned, write Y means the changes have been made in the buffer, and commit ensures that the changes are written to the disk. Now, during these, any of these steps, different type of failures can occur. So what we have to take care? We have to take care about these different levels of problems. Okay. Now, for this, what we want, we will study two type of approaches. Number one is log-based recovery and another is shadow paging. It is very simple. It is something like when you go to a bank and you see and you ask for a transaction, then the person sitting on the system, first of all, notes something in his or her ledger or a copy. That is called as logging. So that in case of any error, he or she can match what all transactions were done in the entire day and whether it is matching to the cash or check or whatever is the case. So the very common approach is used of logs. Now, what are logs? Let us see an example. In case of Oracle, you can see that Oracle is installed in Oracle folder, product folder, Aura data. Here you can see there are three types of files: redo 1, redo 2, redo 3. These are your log files. Okay. So whatever transaction is taking place, first of all, its entry is done in these log files. Then they are written in disk files. Now, since this is my teaching laptop, therefore these log files and data files are at the same place, but in practical projects, these log files are kept in different locations, geographical locations, so that in case this hard disk fails, then the logs can be used to recover the transactions. Okay. So I hope you have understood that although these in this laptop DBFR and log file are at same place, but in practically they are kept at different places. You cannot open these log files. Even if you can open, you cannot understand what is written there. Let us try to understand what is the technology behind this log files. Now, in case of log files, whatever transaction is to be done, it is first of all written in log. And the way of writing is something like this, that if a transaction is started, the log writes T0 start. And it can write what was the value of A when the transaction executes and what was the value of B when it was transferred. For example, before the start, A was 1000 and B was 2000. And after transfer of 50 rupees, A is now 950 and B is now 2050. So this is written in log. Okay. Now you can see here in the log, commit is not written. So if something fails, the system when starts up, it sees that in the log commit is not written. So it can, no action is required. Okay. But if in the log commit is written, then these actions are to be redone. So this is how log works. Okay. Now move to next video. Thank you.